didn't plan this, honestly.
Anna.
Phil.
Phil.
What time's Kathy back?
I don't know why.
Why do you think?
Because it's not right, Sharon.
Not right? It wasn't right when you slept with me in Grant's bed, but you still did it.
Okay, but saying things like that doesn't help with things one little bit, does it? Look, it doesn't matter what you or I or anybody else wants. You said it yourself. The one person in this whole mess who doesn't deserve this kind of crap is Kathy.
You look me in the eye and tell me you don't love me.
I don't love you.
What?
I love Kathy, and I'm gonna marry her. I don't love you anymore.
All right. No, not particularly. I have spent the entire evening picking up babies, giving babies drinks, putting babies down again. Shamila is just as bad as the twins. And when Geeta and Sanjay came back for her, what do I get for my trouble? A bottle of wine. I could have done with the beginning of the evening, not the end.
Do you want a drink?
Oh, yes, please. I'll have a vodka and tonic, please. Has Phil been in yet?
Not that I've seen.
He said he was going to meet me at 10:30. He said, oh, twit's probably falling asleep in front of the telly. How much is that?
Have this on me. Sounds like you've had a bad night.
Right. Cheers. Thanks a lot, pal.
I hope you're proud of yourself, Phil Mitchell.
Hey.
Next time somebody wants a night out, you volunteer your own services, not mine, all right?
Sorry.
No, I've got to go. We screamed for bank rolls up at George Street by now. I wonder, the amount of scotch you got through last night, I hope you've got an headache and all.
I have, Kath. Believe me. I have.
A couple of sticky buns to take out, Kathy, please. Oh.
It's breakfast, is it?
Good Lord, no. 11s, if you don't mind.
Oh, sorry. Oh, hello.
Bart, morning.
Can I get you? I've just come in for a quick coffee, thanks, Kath.
Make that two, will you? I'll join you, if you don't mind.
No, no, not at all. Oh, why don't you sit down? Go on, I'll bring it over.
Oh.
Thank you.
Can't stay long, mind. Got this new course starting this term. I haven't done half the work I'm supposed to on it.
Well, I can't stay either. I haven't finished half the bit yet.
Oh, they won't miss you for a minute or two, will they?
Want a bet?
Come on, you've got to be assertive, Pat. You're entitled to a coffee break. Put your foot down.
Every time I do that, somebody treads on it.
Nonsense. I told you, you've got to be more assertive.
Jeff, there's a lot of people around here who would think I was the most assertive person they know.
Oh. Different people see different things in each other, don't they? Well, that's my 5 minutes of peace and quiet over. See you later.
Yeah.
Do you okay?
Bye then. Oh, yeah. Thank you, bye.
Oh, no.
What are you talking about?
I'm not smoking about anything.
Yes, you are. What's going on?
Nothing's going on. Why do you ask?
Just seeing you sitting there beaming all over your face. That's all.
Well, I like Jeff. He's good company. Makes you laugh.
Well, you certainly seem to get on well together.
Yeah, we do. Well, we've got a lot in common. Not the way we live or anything like that, but just the way we look at things.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, it is. Oh, I've moped around for so long, Kath. They're one disaster after another. I was meeting people that are miserable. Just like to sit down and have a nap. You know, it's like a breath of fresh air.
I know, it's difficult when you've been on your own for a while.
Oh, no, it's not just that. I know I've done the any port in a storm bit more than once. Well, come on, by the time we get to our sort of age, we all live.
Look, Pat, I hope you didn't think I was suggesting anything the other night.
When?
You know, when I was mucking about, when I said about Jeff being after your body and that, I mean, I...
Oh, come on, Kath, don't be silly. Don't take it like that for a minute.
I'll be about an hour or so, all right?
Be as long as you like, I can cope. Right.
No. And I'd like more work than gossip, if you don't mind.
Me? Gossip?
You got a lot to do on this?
Yeah.
Well, do you fancy a break and having some lunch in the Vic?
No, sir.
Come on, 5 minutes won't hurt, yeah?
Yeah, but it won't be 5 minutes, will it? Maybe half an hour to start with, then some idiot will start going on about weddings and getting married and buying us drinks, and that'd be another half an hour, won't it?
What's the matter with you?
Nothing, I've just got a lot on, that's all.
Oh, yeah, and the rest. And
what's that supposed to mean?
Well, you've been horrible since you woke up.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry, I've got a bit of hangover.
I'm not surprised. I can see you put away that much scotch for some time.
Yeah, well, I like to keep me handy, don't I?
Yeah, and then it was because you were in a state about other things. So, come on, what's going on there?
Well, there's nothing going on, all right? I was bored. There was nothing on the box. You were out, so I had a few drinks, all right?
Oh, so it's my fault, is it?
What do you have to go out for, anyway?
All right. Well, that's it, then. You're either still drunk, you're going to start raving mad. I'll talk to you when you're feeling human again, if that ever happens. It's just times when I can't get through to him at all.
Well, you was out to lunch.
Well, I'm not now, all right?
So, what happened? Did you have a row?
Natalie, can you pop over the laundrette for us and ask Caroline if I could have any washing bags?
I'm not a flaming servant yet, you know.
Yeah, and you're not unemployed yet, either. So go on. Well, there's nothing to say, really. I mean, we've been getting on great. We always do get on great. That's why I'm marrying the man. It's just sometimes, when there's something on his mind, he goes into his own little world and there's nothing you can do about it.
And you've got no idea what's wrong?
It's probably something really trivial, Michelle. He's just playing these silly little guessing games that get on my nerves.
Yeah.
You don't fancy coming over the Vic lunchtime, do you? Rivers, keep me company.
Not really, no. I've just been driven out of there, to be honest. I don't want to go back.
What do you mean you're driven out of there? I've been dancing on the tables again, have you?
No, no, nothing like that. It's the ever-present Pat that's a problem.
What?
Well, I don't know what's wrong with a woman. It's suddenly, everywhere I go, whatever I do, there's Pat. It's nothing horrible or anything, but it's, you know, she's picking Vicky up and she's always sitting with us in the pub.
Oh, Lord.
What?
Does she do it when you're on your own?
Well, no, no, only when I'm with... What do you think she fancies?
She thinks he fancies her. Oh, I'm really sorry, Michelle, it's all my fault.
Well, why? What?
Well, it was when you and Jeff were in the pub the other night, you know, and you went out to talk to your friends.
Yeah, I remember.
Well, Jeff was obviously telling Pat a joke, and they were laughing and that, and when I left, I just said, you want to watch it, he's only after your body.
What?
Well, I didn't mean it, Michelle, I was just teasing her, honestly.
What, and she believed you?
Well, I tried to talk to her about it, you know, explain to her, just winding her up, and she says it's not like that, but you could see it in her face, Michelle.
This is awful.